Good morning, students. Welcome back to the English grammar class. I hope you all are doing well. So in today's video, I am coming with a new chapter about articles. So today we will learn about articles and different types of articles, how we can use and where we cannot use, and all about this. Okay? So there are three articles in English. A, an, and the. They are called articles because as they have significant role as parts of speech. They are also called determiners, as they affect the meaning of noun. So there are two types of articles, like indefinite articles and definite articles. Indefinite article. A and an are called indefinite articles because they are used when we do not speak of any particular person or thing. When we are not talking about any particular thing or particular person, we are using a or an. Just like a is used before consonants, an is used before vowel. Like a king, a book, a table, and an orange, an umbrella, an eye, then indefinite article. So here I have a chart how we can use the indefinite article a and an. So in the first table I have written use of a before consonants, and the right side a before vowel sounding as yo and wo. Okay, so here look at the examples, like a box, a mobile, a glass, a boy, a pen, a teacher, a cat, a shirt, a pant. So you can say anything. That is, if you are using a consonant sounds, if the word have the consonant sounds, you can use the article like a. So you are using indefinite article a before the consonants. And we have also a vowel sounding as yo and wo. They have vowel letters, but still then there we are using I. So a before vowel sounding as yo and wo. Okay, in spite of they have later the vowel letter in the word, we are using a before it. Just like a ology, a European, a university, a utensil, a one day, a match, a unique book, a one-eyed man, a one rupee note. So these are the words that have all the vowel, but still then they have sounding have like yo and wo. So that's why we are using indefinite article a before it. Thereafter, second table, the use of an before vowel sound. Okay, an we can use in the before the vowel sound, just like an eye, an apple, an ass, an orange, an umbrella, an ant, an aunt, an order. So in these of the words we can see the first letter have vowel sound. So in these sentences, these are the words we can use indefinite article an. On the right side, an before consonant sounding as vowel. Okay, the some of the words that have contains the consonants, but still then they have sounding just like a vowel. Like an hour, an air, an honest, an MA. That is capital MA written by mistakenly. Thereafter, an MP, an NAC, NCC, an SDO, an MLA. So in these are the words, we can see the all the words have that consonant sound, but still then they are sounding as just like a vowel. That's why we are using the words using the indefinite article an.
There are two rules. So here we can use indefinite article. Just like when we are not referring to something or someone else in a specific way. Just like I saw a man standing outside our house. So I just saw a man. Though I am not talking about a particular man, how he's looking, how is this wearing. I am not talking about like that. So I am just I saw a man. Clear it? Just like in the sense of one. So in the sense of one, we can use the indefinite article. Like I can say I have bought a new house. Means I have bought one house. And sometimes we can use one instead of a. You can use it. Okay, I can say I have a shirt. And I can also say I have one shirt. Okay, the meaning will same. And thereafter with the meaning each. Like I read at least one book a month. That means each and every month I read one book. So in that sense also we can use a. And thereafter with the names of occupations. When we are talking about someone's occupations, so you can use the indefinite article a or an. Like a doctor, a teacher, an engineer. So there are all the most of the occupations. So we can use the occupations. You can use the indefinite article before the names of occupations. Thereafter, in expressions of speed, price, and ratio. The bus travel at 40 km an hour. So here is showing about the speed. So you can use there an before it. And another is numerical expressions. Means just like a number you can expressions. Just like a dozen banana, a thousand years. So there are these are the words that are showing the numbers, numerical expressions. So in that sense we can use the indefinite article a. Then indefinite article is omitted. Means no need to use there. So we cannot use the indefinite article there. Where if the noun is uncountable. If there's uncountable noun, so you cannot use the indefinite article there. Just like sand is used in making glass. Clear? So here glass is an uncountable noun and sand is also an uncountable noun. So no need to use the indefinite article. Then when a noun is the name of a meal, just like a breakfast, lunch, tiffin or dinner. So in that case, so no need to use the indefinite article. Thereafter, in case of plural form, we use some or any. Okay, so there is no plural of the indefinite article. So in that sense, we can use some or any. Okay, so I saw some horses in the field. So no need to use the indefinite article. We can use instead of that some or any. I didn't eat any bananas. Then definite article. So the is the noun. Definite article. The is known as the definite article. It is used when we refer to a particular person or thing. Just to opposite of the indefinite article. Like he is wearing the shirt which he bought yesterday. Means he is wearing that particular shirt that he had bought yesterday. So we are talking about that particular shirt. So definite article is used. Where we can use definite article. So there are some rules. Just look. First one. When there is only one in existence. Means when one in existence in the universe. There we can use the definite article. Like the sun. The sea. Just like. Because the sun is the only one in the universe. We didn't have any two sun. Okay. The second one. When the reader knows which one is referred to. Okay. Just like example. Give the book. Sorry. Give me the book. means the reader knows which book he wants, which book he is now asking. Means he give me the book, means I give it, I have already given some books, so that book he was asking, give me the book, the particular book he was asking. So reader knows about which one is report. So in that case we can use the definite article. Then to represent a class of people. Okay, if the word that is represent to a class of people, just like the scheme is meant for the poor. Okay, this scheme is meant for the poor. So here poor is a class of the people, poor class of people. It refers to the poor class of people. So that's why we are using the word the. We are using the definite article the before it. And then before oceans, seas, rivers, deserts. Just like the Ganga, the Thar, the Bay of Bengal, etc. Like so the Ganga is the name of the river, the Thar is the name of the desert, the Bay of the Bengal, just like our seas. So you can use these words before these oceans, seas, and rivers and deserts. And then before names of hotels, cinemas, theaters, and ships. He usually stays at the Taj Hotel. Okay, he usually stays at the Taj Hotel. So Taj Hotel is the name of the hotel. So we can use here before the word noun Taj as a the. We can use the word indefinite article the. And thereafter, before ordinal numbers. Ordinal numbers, na cardinal and ordinal. So ordinal numbers are just like first, second, third, fourth, just. So in before that ordinal numbers, we can use definite article the. Then with superlative adjectives. So when we have adjectives have 3 degrees, like positive, comparative, and superlative. So in the superlative adjective degrees, we can use the word the. Okay, we can use the definite article the. Just like he is the tallest boy in our class. Okay, so before the word adjective, superlative adjective, I use the word the. So another is with the singular noun represents a whole class of things. Just like the atomic bomb was invented in 1944. Singular noun, but represent the whole class of bomb. Thereafter, with the names of newspapers and magazines. Okay, if the names of newspapers and magazines, we can use the word, we can use the definite article. Just like the Times of India, the Illustrated Weekly. Okay, just like that. For the names of certain well-known books, just like the Bible, the Ramayana, the Mahabharata, etc. and so on and so on. Before plural proper names. Just like the Indians live in India, the English are fond of adventure. Okay, the Indians live in India. Indians means here belongs to the people. So the peoples live in India. Okay, they are called Indians. Okay. Like the English means the people of the England. The English that doesn't mean the subject of English. The English means that is the people of the England. So before certain expressions of time, okay, certain expressions of time like in the morning, in the afternoon, on the previous day, so just like expressions. Okay, we can use the words definite article. And thereafter, definite article is omitted. When in the some of the cases, we no need, we cannot use the definite article. So where? First one, before plural nouns used for a whole class. Okay, plural nouns that used for a whole class. Just like snakes are often dangerous. So here snakes is belongs to a whole class of the snake. So that's why we don't need to use the definite article. And then before uncountable nouns with general meaning. Okay, he studied history. So it's generally meaning, general meaning is studied history. History is uncountable noun, and he studied history. He studied American history, medieval history, Indian history, anything. So he studied history. So in that case, no need to use the definite article. Then, before the names of languages used as nouns. Okay, before the names of languages, just like he learned English, he learned Hindi, he learned Russian, he learned Japanese. So all these languages names, no need to use, cannot use the definite article. And another one, in expressions for means of travel used generally. Okay, when you are expressing something, the means of travel, means of transportations, so you cannot use the definite article. Okay, just like you can say simply by rail, by bus, or by road, or by air. In certain other expressions, just like at home, on top, on foot, on loan. So in these cases, so you cannot use a definite article. Okay, just like you can say he stayed at home to receive the guest. Okay, and some of the factors are there. So there is a difference in meaning between the two sentences without using the word definite and using the definite article. You can say he has gone to church. He has gone to the church. So to church, that means they're simply giving the meaning that he has gone to church for the usual purpose, just like to prayer, just like to worship the God. Okay, but if you're using the word indefinite article the before the noun church, so he has gone to the church, that means that he has gone there for some other purpose. Okay, possibly to do a job, or possibly to talk to someone else. Okay, not for the worship. So if you are using the before some places, like just like a church or school or college, so that means that he is going somewhere else, he has gone somewhere else for the different purpose, not for the usual purpose. So in the school, you can say he didn't come to school. Okay, he didn't come to school. Means he didn't come to the learn, didn't come to the study. Okay, I can say my father came to the school. Means my father came to the school to talk with the principal, or to talk with the class teacher, or to pay the fees, any work. Okay. So in this way, we finished our chapter article. I hope you understand well. So thank you students for being with me at the last of this video. So you can learn more about articles just following your book. In books, there are some many rules and many some tricks are also there. So you can also try to complete the assignments of the chapter. So I will meet you in my next video with some exciting topics and exciting tricks. So till then, see you, take care, bye.